Frigid here once again. Alright, so fortunately, Terraria or T-Mod Loader isn't being doofy now. Not sure what the heck was going on before. Plans for this little area concerning hard mode. Might want to expand it a smidge. Oh. I'll expand it vertically. Not sure about whether to do so up or down, though. Maybe both. Going down. I guess it's a vine or something. I thought it was an arrow. And it's not like it would have clutched it if it was. It's just... You don't see, like, some random arrow just lying around someplace. I mean, you're not gonna see some random arrow just lying around someplace in this game. At least not without breaking a pot or two. I'm really glad that the instivator is an item you can craft with one of the mods that I've got loaded. Not quite sure which one it is. Because, good lordy, making one yourself without an item like that would be so freaking tedious. Camera mode. Huh. Oh, what's the button for using my mount? You know, for mounting or dismounting. Oh, it's R. Did I have to dismount from the minecart as well? That is cute, dude. R is right by the WASD keys, so there's that. Single player, so why is the game lagging like this? That's some really thick lava. Or viscous. No. Whistle? Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, it is. That's right, I forgot. I guess there's an attack. I guess there's an attack used by the golem just by it died. Oh. game keep lagging like that? This is single player. Oi. Place for some honey. There it is. Dirt. That's for sure. I'll have to keep that in mind. Bag. I don't think I've gotten that before. Oh! I see, it only drops during Halloween. That's why I've never gotten it before. That's different. Hold still, dang it. That bright red orb. With a freaking Zen potion, still having to fight off enemies constantly. Think that'll be enough? Probably not. Oh, good grief. Thank you. found the lab. I think they would have a bit further to go. And I'm in. Good. Is it? Where'd I get that from? Does stack too, but I'm not gonna get more of it anytime soon. Hmm. good. Already found that one. Character isn't named Jetstream Sam, so I can't use it yet. What is that? Realm with history dating back more than a millennium. The crags, are first settled and acts as a glance into both the modern and ancient world simultaneously. Prior to any joining of Yarm's forces, Azafura was in the center of scientific advancement in the world of explosives, firearms, smithing techniques, and even entire schools of magic have roots in the city. It is doubtless that the city has been largely aided by the fact that fortune is trivial in the underworld, along with an abundance of food due to Silva's essence dripping down from the abyss above. Due to this, it has prospered even with the occasional attack from demons. Azafura has not existed without consequence, of course. Any society on such a large scale leaves an ecological footprint behind. This can be seen most clearly in the sea far above the city, appropriately known as the Sulphurous Sea. Brimstone fumes became intense enough for the city that they began rising up through the abyss as a process akin to osmosis, and eventually reached the sea. Reducing the pollution the city creates, particularly from forging, is a goal Yarm wishes for me to prioritize. I see little need in it, and it is a field of study few in the world have delved into. I refuse to squander an opportunity for a scientific breakthrough. That must be the wall of flesh. A particular being here has been the subject of my interest. A massive wall created from biological material lies in this place, created many years ago by the greatest mages Azure has to offer. It is a living being, though only just. It lacks both pain and emotion, and brings terror to all who lay their eyes upon it. It is kept protected via high security by the city, and so few aside from the god seekers and closest allies have had the opportunity to observe it. As long as Azafura continues to stand, it is unlikely to ever be truly released. Yet, I do not deny that I would be fascinated to see the effects of its release, or to see the effects its release would have on the world. Yeah, that'll be what you wish for, I guess. put it there for now, I guess. That's where I was keeping the rusted pipes. Thank you. right. Oh, there he is. So you can just make the portable, right? Trapper bulb, murky paste, jungle spores. So you need the trapper bulb, which I'm pretty sure drops from an enemy that only shows up in hard mode. Shoot, there's a lot of those. How does that stack up to the one I've got? Let's see, 25 versus 31.25, 13.5. Wheelback velocity is a lot harder. I think there's a lot higher. So the cold velocity, might as well try to craft it. Fire debuffs don't damage you. That's gonna be useful. Let's see. Buff effects work for town NPCs while equipped during your inventory. While you're burning, attacks are accompanied by balls of fire, grants immunity to oiled, reduces damage from touching lava. That seems like it's gonna be really handy. Yes, I do. Pass on that. Yeah. got stuff to sell you. Ain't a bridge. Just stuff. Sure, why not? Again, why not? There's the buzzer. So, as always, folks, do not stop being awesome, and I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.